Green Frontier Cannabis Conference hosted by SmallCapPower. We're talking to Matei Olaru, the CEO of Lyft & Co., which is listed on the TSX Venture Exchange as Lyft. Matei, welcome to SmallCapPower.
Thank you. It's a pleasure to be here.
So for our viewers who are not aware of Lyft & Co., you describe it as the TripAdvisor of the cannabis world?
Definitely. Our consumer-facing asset is TripAdvisor, and we monetize what we view as the Nielsen part of our business, which is market insights and data analytics that we gather from that TripAdvisor-like platform of cannabis reviews and product listings.
So you're sitting on this wealth of consumer data, product information, consumer insights. What do you do with that? How do you monetize that?
Mm-hmm. Well, it's interesting because the cannabis industry is so new. So right now what we're doing is we're empowering producers and retailers, for example, to better understand what products are selling to whom and perhaps what to grow next or what product to stock from their wholesale supplier in their province. It's really about marketing and understanding your customer better.
And this might seem like a very simple business proposition, but there's a big space for this and there's a big gap in the market.
Mm-hmm. It's actually such a robust value proposition in the sense that we know from data we can get actionable insights into running our business better, and that is the world of data analytics. But we take that one step further, and what we do with Lyft is not just provide you with the insights, which we gather from our rewards program or our receipt collection or our reviews on Lyft.co, but we actually empower you as a producer or a retailer to better market your products through a series of content, events, and rewards incentives that we host digitally on Lyft.co that directly reach those cannabis consumers.
So apart from your website and your events, you've also launched a Cannabis Concierge and a rewards program. Talk to us about that.
We did. So the Cannabis Concierge is something we're very excited about. It's a tablet power tool, which is starting to be rolled out across retailers in Canada. And really what it does is when you walk as a store attendee, working at the store or a customer, you'll be able to input a number of characteristics and the concierge will recommend you products in the cannabis industry that you might want to try based on what you've tried in the past. And we complement that with our rewards program, which you mentioned. By writing reviews on Lyft, we will give you points that you can redeem for gift cards at Starbucks, Indigo, Amazon, really large retailers, to incentivize you to come back to the platform and really share more with us about your experience with cannabis.
And you're also now dabbling into training talent and grooming the next generation of cannabis budtainers.
Mm-hmm. We are, and really what it is, it's an LMS platform that Lyft hosts, a learning management system that is directly plugged into retailers, both private and government-run retailers. And what we've done is the first content we've put on that platform is a retail training certification that Lyft has developed with Mothers Against Drug Driving Canada. And what this platform does is we now have direct collaboration with the bud tenders. So as brands come online and retailers look to be educated by the producers, Lyft & Co. has a direct access point to those bud tenders. And the MAD Canada training is really just the first such touch point we'll have with them.
You're also a bit of an expert in the marijuana space, Matei. What do you make of the environment right now, 30 days since cannabis was legalized as we speak today? You know, there was a poll saying that people are still returning back to their black market suppliers. So is supply the biggest challenge for the industry?
I think supply is the biggest challenge for the industry getting off the ground. And that's for a number of reasons. One, sure, you can't find product, but two, there's no variety of product to attract consumers that have access to illegal channels currently. And for new time consumers, an extra wrinkle is the fact that Ontario, the largest population in the country, doesn't have direct brick and mortar access. So you have an environment where new customers can't even get to the product and old customers can't even get product they want. So it is just a sign of the times, brand new industry, and we will roll out eventually, but it is a bit of a hiccup.
And that's where Lyft & Co. comes in to spread the education and tell people what they're buying.
Exactly. And from a retailer perspective, let's say, there's a supply shortage. So you must ask yourselves, okay, I'm going to try and get product A and B, but which one should I really care about? And that's where Lyft data can come in handy, right? We help retailers make better stocking decisions by telling them what sells in this region and perhaps the demographic, and helping them make better purchase decisions so they can run their business better.
Wonderful. Matei, wish you all the best. Thank you for your time.
Thank you so much. It's been a pleasure.